looking good. I think we're ready to rattle. That's what we're gonna do first around the edges. This before the amber that's gonna coat the whole body. I thought about doing the amber first and then doing this, but it was recommended to do this first, and then if you need to sand the top at all or the back at all, you're able to do so before you put on the amber. A properly rattled can will also have little dents in the bottom. I read that online. So basically, you just shake the crap out of this thing until you get little dents or divots. See, I didn't use any grain filler or anything like that. I'm just taking a look around the guitar. I still am gonna flip it over and spray again. But we're getting a lot of absorption into the wood, which I expected because I didn't put grain filler in or sealer or do any of that stuff. I wanna go for the wood feel. But here's kind of our moment of truth. I'm going to see how easily this will come up because I'm going to flip over the guitar. Oh, we're feeling pretty good about this now, okay. We won't save that because I'm going to have to flip it over. We're pretty good. This will all be covered in that brown. This is nice and faded. This whole area will be covered with the pick guard, so I wasn't really concerned about that. And I'm going to be going over the dark brown and the fade. Okay, here we are. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little bit nervous. I've never done sunburst before. I know there's some limitations or, I mean, you're using a rattle can, right? Spray can, so the amount of control, I don't know. I'm not used to using airbrush, any of that stuff. But I think for safety's sake, I'm going to start on the backside here and, do my best, you know. We'll see how that turns out. I'm pretty pleased with the way it's turned out right now. I followed a lot of instructions online. I've watched a ton of videos, but none of that really matters until you do it firsthand. So here we go.
We shed our torture.